Everyone, today we are going to learn how to change first character of the string into uppercase letter. Okay, suppose we have given a string like hello world. So only we need to change first character into uppercase letter. So it should be like hello world. Suppose our given string like hello, then output should be, so only we need to convert first character, so it should be hello only. Suppose our string start with backslash and we have hello world, so output should be backslash, because we will try to convert first character of the string into uppercase letter. So backslash will be first character, so rest of the character should remain as it is. So hello world, output should be like this. Okay, suppose this one is space is there in the string and we have hello world, then output should be first space then hello world. Okay, so first we need to learn how to convert a string into uppercase letter. To convert a string into uppercase letter, we can make use of two uppercase method. Suppose our given string is hello world, so we can convert this string to uppercase character by using this method. Okay, so we can print output on the screen by making use of console.log. So we will run this program and see the output. See here hello world. So all characters in this string is converted to uppercase. Suppose I had only hello, then it will print hello. Okay, suppose I had here h only, so h will convert it to capital letter. Suppose I had empty string, so we will have nothing here. Okay, suppose I had first character as special character like slash, then slash will get printed. Okay, by using two uppercase method. Suppose I had space here, then space will get printed. See here space will get printed. Okay, so suppose here I had h, then h will be converted to capital letter h. Okay, suppose if I will add this h with remaining string. So in this hello world, see line number 16, we have h as a first letter, we have this character as a remaining characters. Okay, only h will get converted into uppercase letter and we will print our remaining letters as it is. So now we will run this program. So see hello world will get printed. So our main task is we need to separate first character and remaining characters. To separate it, we can apply slash method. Okay, so our string is this one, so it start from 0 index, then 1 index, 2nd index, 3rd index, up to last index, and last index is 10th index, and 10th index denotes to D character. Okay, so we have our string into some variable like bar str equal to hello world. Okay, so we can have variable like bar first character, so first character will be str dot slice method. So we need to read only first character h. See line number 19, we need to read only first character. So we will start from 0th index, because first character will be available at 0 index, and we need to read only one character, which is first character h. So we will define length, pass second argument as 1, okay, and we can have variables like remaining characters, okay. So we can print remaining character with slash method, and here we can pass only single argument, because remaining characters will start from first one index, okay. We have already read first character, which is available at 0th index, and so we will start reading from one index, okay. So we will start from e character and we will go till the end, okay. So we can only pass here one argument, which is start index. We will pass one, and end index is optional. Second argument is optional. If we want to pass, we can pass. This string have 11 characters, we can pass 11, but it is optional. Anyhow, it will read all the remaining characters. It will start from one index, it will start from e character, and it will read all remaining characters. So we can print these variables. So console.log, first we will print first char, then we will print remaining characters, okay, cool. So now we will run this program and we will see the output. See, so we have splitted h and remaining characters into two parts. So see line number 31. So this variable first character will have h. So we can write here our first character. So here at line number 31, we are converting first character to uppercase letter. See, here to here, okay. And so we will append remaining characters with h. So I can write remaining characters, okay. So now I will run this program and we will see the output. Hello world, okay. See, h is converted to capital letter h. See line, see third printed value, okay, cool. So string can be anything. So this is a dynamic program, so it will work with any string. So string can be like, we can have only hello, so it will print hello. H should be capital letter. So we can have first character as a space also, so we will print. So only it will have a space here, and so first character only we need to convert first character into uppercase letter. So we won't touch a remaining character, which is hello and world. So we will touch only first character, which is space. Suppose we have slash here, then so first character will be slash only, okay. We can have numeric value also here like 2, so it will print 2 hello world, okay. 4 characters it will convert into hello world. Suppose we have already capital letter as a first character, then we will already have capital letter first character as a capital letter, cool. So what we can do, we can put this logic into a function. So with any string and anywhere in our program, we can call this function. So we can have function like function capitalize first character. Okay. So here we will have parameter, and we will have this logic into this function. So we will call this function and we will pass a string as argument. So we will pass hello world as argument. Now we will run this program and we will see the output. See hello world. So anywhere in the program we can call this function and we can convert first character of the string into capital letter. So here we are at line number 28, we are printing this string here itself. So in this function, instead of printing, we can return this value. So we will use return keyword and we will return this string. So whenever we will call this function, this will return some value. Okay, H will be capital and it will return this value only, hello world. So we need to capture this value in some variable. So we can have variable like returned value, returned str. Okay, so we can have variable like return string, returned string, and we can print return string into at line number 33. Okay, so again we will run this program and we will see the output. So return string. We can call this function anywhere in the program and it will return at line number 29, it will return a string with first character as uppercase letter. Okay, cool. Thank you.